Let's study Moseley's law. This law is basically used to relate the frequency of characteristic axes with the atomic number of the anode element. Let's study it step by step. We know that the wavelength of characteristic axes can be obtained by modified Rydberg's formula, which is generally used for emission of any line spectrum which is emitted from a heavy element, which is given as 1 by lambda is equals to Rz minus sigma square 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Here lambda is the wavelength of photon corresponding to the transition of electron from orbit N2 to N1 in the element with the atomic number Z. And here we write sigma is the screening constant, which accounts the shielding effect of nucleus by the outer electrons. And here Z minus sigma, we write it as Z effective, called effective atomic number of the element, which is corresponding to a specific transition. Because we know that for different transitions, the value of a screening constant will be different. And here we can write, if nu is the frequency of emitted X-rays, then we can use the frequency nu, we can write as C by lambda, and in this situation, this will become RC Z minus sigma square. We are just substituting the value of 1 by lambda, which is the wave number, is 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Now, in this situation, for a given transition, RC, N1 and N2 are constants. So, we just replace it by a constant. This will become, just by taking the square root, we can write root nu is equals to A Z minus sigma. And in this situation, we can see the value of A is under the root RC 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square is a constant for a given transition of electron between specified orbits. So, in this relation, we can see that the square root of frequency is linearly related with the atomic number of the anode element, and this specific rule we call Moseley's law. If we just plot a variation graph between frequency of emitted radiation or X-rays with the atomic number of the element, this will be the straight line with a positive slope and a negative intercept on the frequency axis. So, this is the way how Moseley's law is analyzed.